Oh, sorry. Hi! Good morning, everybody. Welcome to another Jubilant Saturday, August the 13th, 2022. Another weekend is upon us. This one is episode 810, part 1. And in this one, we're going to be learning about position and condition. Ooh, sounds like a good one, don't it? Beginning with Colossians 3, verse 1, compiled by Henry M. Morris. So if you're excited about another Jubilant Saturday, smash the like button. Comment what's your weekend plans? What's your weekend plans for this weekend? Got anything special you're doing this weekend? Let me know. And if it's special, especially you need prayer for something, let me know. And I'll pray for you about it. But subscribe if you're new. Turn on notifications. Share the video and channel with your family and friends. Help me reach that 100 subscriber mark by the first day of fall. Like I've always said, the middle of September, so that's like 4 weeks away now. So, and if I believe right, somewhere between the 15th and 18th. It's the first day of fall this year. So, and it's usually each season change, it's usually on the same, from like the 19th to the 22nd. Usually when it's lined up, but this year it's a little bit earlier than usual. But if you can do that for me, I will greatly appreciate each and every one that helps me get there. Without further ado, let's learn about position and condition. Colossians 3:1 says, "If ye then be risen with Christ, seek those things which are above, where Christ sitteth on the right hand of God." So Christians have a glorious position before God. And as the passage I just read indicates, God has in effect already raised us up together and made us sit together in heavenly places in Christ Jesus, Ephesians 2 verse 6. But yet our actual spiritual condition here on earth often seems to belie our exalted position in heaven. So we repeatedly need to be exhorted not only to believe the truth, but also to live the truth. Amen? Theoretically, we are dead to the world, and our life is hid with Christ in God. Yet we must continually be exhorted to mortify, that is, put to death, therefore your members which are upon the earth. Colossians 3, verses 3 and 5. And we have put on the new man, but nevertheless must repeatedly be renewed in the knowledge after the image of him that created him. Verse 10. So while in doctrine we are complete in him, in practice we must grow in grace and in the knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. 2 Peter 3:18. With the heart man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. Yet each believer is commanded to follow after righteousness and to work out your own salvation. Romans 10:10, 1 Timothy 6:1, Philippians 2:12. So when I said that with the heart man believeth is Romans 10:10, yet each believer is commanded, follow after righteousness is 1 Timothy 6:11. And work out your own salvation is Philippians 2:12. We are all children of light, 1 Thessalonians 5:5. We are to walk as children of light, Ephesians 5:8. And Paul prays that Christ may dwell in your hearts by faith, Ephesians 3:17. Yet already we have Christ in you, the hope of glory, Colossians 1:27. So these truths are not contradictions, of course, but exhortations. If, and the Greek word actually means since, we are risen with Christ, then by all means, we ought to live as those that are alive unto God. Amen? So coming up tomorrow, in another glorious Lord's Day Sunday, August the 14th, 2022, episode 811, part 1, we're going to be talking about a non-citizen's role in society. Beginning with Ephesians 2:19, and compiled by John D. Morris. So, stay tuned for that. I'll get to that later tonight, but you'll see that one tomorrow. Coming up at 5:45 today, which is no turning point this evening, we're going to be talking about part 2 of 8, episode 810, your daily bread passage for your Saturday, August the 13th. And we're going to be talking about Monstro, M-O-N-S-T-R-O, Monstro, the goldfish. From Elisha Morgan, derived from Luke 10:27-37. So, stay tuned to that. I'll get to that one in just a few minutes, but you'll see that one. But our weekend reading for the turning point, I'm going to go ahead and give you a preview of that one. I'll give you another preview in the evening video, but your weekend, I'll give you the full weekend outlook after the video, the second video at the end. But your Bible reading for the weekend is Jeremiah 31-36. So if you read 31, 32, and 33 today, and then read the other three tomorrow. So, I'm just giving you a heads up on that one for the Bible reading. So you can go ahead and get it. Go ahead and read the three verses, the three chapters, and then. But, come, wait a minute. So, with that said, I love you. I appreciate you. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Keep on keeping on and trusting God. He'll keep you safe and all you say and do in 2022 and beyond. And until later, peace out, everybody. So long, farewell. Come back later after 5:45 and we'll be talking about Monstro the Goldfish. Sounds interesting. So until then, God bless everyone. And I'll see you later. Goodbye.